Okay, Cats Cradle fans, we are very, very privileged to have a genuine yogi instructor here. Or is it yoga instructor?
Yoga instructor.
Yoga instructor.
A yogi is someone who practices yoga.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Namaste.
And she refers to herself as Yogi Mandhi, right?
Yogi, Mandhi is my name, but Mandhi is the is the yogi name. Yogi Mandhi.
And she's going to stick with us because Yogi Mandhi is going to go over to the exercise area and show you a little bit about how to do yoga. And if you like what you see, hopefully you'll contact Yogi Mandhi and ask for some additional instruction.
Yes, yes, please. I'm a private yoga instructor. I help people one-on-one, helping using yoga as a form of therapy. So today we're going to do an easy 30-minute yoga session for lower back pain. And it's all on the mat, no standing, so it should be really easy. So I hope you join us.
Okay, stay tuned. We're going to move over to the yoga area where we're going to see all these wonderful things, and all of your pains are going to go away immediately.
Yes, yes. Like that. Okay, because that's what yoga does. All right. Okay, let's do this, baby. Hi, babies. Oh. On the way. Hello, hello, babies. Hi. You like my music playlist?
Right, so hang on. Yogi Mandhi is
all right.
On her way to her mat.
We are on the mat.
Started with her instruction.
And it is bright. All right, let's check out our space. Can you see the whole area? Looks pretty good. Wow. Okay, so if you're joining for yoga, let's come on our mat. I'm going to restart this playlist over. All right, let's just come to a child's pose. So child's pose is you'll come on your knees and flatten your toes. Bring your right on top of your left big toe for more support. Back on your heels as much as able to sit back all the way. Maybe put a cushion underneath here and sit on the cushion. Okay? Then from here, just stretch your arms out, stretching your spine as long as you can. Reaching your arms out, relax your head down. And now here in this child's pose, let's take a few breaths in through the nose, out through the nose, or in through the mouth, out through the mouth. Breathe as long as you're breathing. Let's reach our hands out just a little bit more. Lengthening the spine. Now let's lift our head up and walk our arms over to the right side. Arching over to the right. Kind of creating this curvature with your body. And just take a deep belly breath, breathing into this left side. let's walk our hand back center and to the left, arching over to the left, relaxing it. Center. Now let's slowly come up into tabletop. So tabletop, we're going to bring our hands under our shoulders, our knees under our hips. So we're making this tabletop position. And let's first just warm up our joints, rocking front to back, right in the spotlight, right in the sunlight. Front to back, side to side. Maybe doing some circles. Maybe moving like in a semicircle. And now let's come back to tabletop. We're gonna do some cow-cat breaths. So basically, we'll be arching and rounding our breath, or not our breath, but our spine as we breathe. And so, starting from a neutral flat back, maybe I can turn, I think you can see me there. We're gonna start with our tailbone moving first. So let's arch our spine. First, move your tailbone. Rotate towards the sky. Drop your belly, arching spine. And then lift your chin up. So here, your tailbone and your chin are both lifting. The abdomen is arching down towards the ground. And now tuck your tailbone under. Hello, kitty. Drop your head and round your back into cat pose as a kitty cat walks up. Hi, sweetheart. Come here. Hi. So here we're in cat pose. Now rotate your tailbone again out. Inhaling. Coming into cow pose. Inhale, and now exhale as you tuck your tailbone under, rounding your spine. And again, move your tailbone first, rolling out like a wave, lifting your chin. Keep your elbows straight here. Sometimes they tend to buckle. And let's just take a few breaths here, cow-cat breaths. Inhaling into cow. Exhale, rounding out. Yeah, she came up right when I was doing cat pose. Hi, licorice. So now let's come back into child's pose. We're going to sit back on our heels, reach out the arms, bringing the chest and the head down as much as you can. If you can't go all the way down, maybe just bend your elbows and come on your forearms. If you have a pillow or some blocks, you can also rest on top of there. But just do what you can. And then within that pose, see where you can breathe and relax. Each asana or each pose should be Stidham Sukham Asana, meaning comfortable yet stable, where you can breathe. So let's come up. And now we're going to come into a cobra. So an easy way to do this is maybe come into a sphinx. So we're going to come all the way on our bellies. And bring your elbow underneath your shoulders. And your toes are flat. Maybe together or hip distance. And If you feel you can take it a little bit more, bring your hands like that. And then as you're in this pose, inhale in. Down on rotate your toes outward in your heels and relax your head down one way. We're gonna roll on over. Coming on our back, yes. Oh. Okay. Thank you.
There you go.
Is it on now?
It should be on now.
Okay. All right.
So when you're rolling that side.
Yeah, it wasn't on the side, just on my belly. Oh, but okay. Oh, when I went this way?
Yeah.
Okay. Gotcha. Yeah, it's kind of hard to find a spot you don't roll. We're learning here. Oh, yeah, yeah. All right. Bring our feet flat on the ground. And let's just drop our knees one side and then to the other. And just a nice, slow, rhythmic pace. Let's bring our knee. And again, let's just rock gently, side to side, massaging our back, massaging our spine. Right knee, and extend your left leg. Gently hugging this right knee in. Stretch your ankles out. And just take some easy breaths here in Bhavanamuktasana. Let's bring this right knee, and we're just going to cross all over the body. Now, as you're twisting, keep this right shoulder and both shoulders on the ground. Maybe the right arm. One left arm. Knees back, our chest, this
if you hear the mic going in and out, it's because
at the same time, keep the left shoulder
Yogi's
down,
rolling around,
extend the left arm out
on top
as
of,
you
of her
twist
mic transmitter.
Left knee over.
So it's my fault for using that type of microphone. We'll do something
sometimes,
different next time.
But if you scooch
she's
back,
the
yes, that's a proper term, scooch. Scooch your bottom hip back.
We're losing.
And then it will give you some more space to twist.
Of
but don't come. Don't
some benefit
you know, bring
porch.
This left shoulder up to compensate. Shoulders are down first, then see where you can twist. Breathing. Let's bring both knees into the chest. And rock side to side. And now let's rock. Again, this thing slow. Some momentum, some speed. Be careful not to roll the neck. And see if you can roll yourself up. If not, that is okay. You can come up another way. And let's come up into Sukhasana, a cross-legged seat. So if this is not comfortable for you, there are other options. You can put a cushion under your tushin, and put a cushion under your seat, lifting up the tailbone. That can release some tension on the lower back, make it a little bit easier to sit. If your hips are a little tight and it's a little uncomfortable, if you have a cushion you can put underneath, or maybe some blocks to hold you up there, that's also another option. But let's go to seated cross position. Sitting up tall. Let's bring our hands to our knees. And we're just going to start some rocking side to side. And actually, before we begin the rocking, take a look at your feet. Whatever leg is in front naturally, just bring that foot slightly out. And we're going to do some Kundalini circles. So let's just first start side to side. And then let's come down low, bending our elbows up. Rocking side to side, down low. And now we're going to go in a circle. So bring your head forward, your whole body reaching forward. And then come to the left. Back, maybe rounding your back like in cat pose. Come to the right. And then forward. And then, maybe starting small, just find your circle. Circling around to the left. If you want to incorporate your breath with that, you can inhale as you come down low, maybe arching your spine. Bring the back. If that's too much, just and breathe. And find a nice rhythmic flow with your breath and movement. Cats in the cradle and sail the spoon. Now let's come forward and we're going to go to the other side, to the right. So start slow. As you transition, test it out. Sometimes one way is totally different than the other, or one side may be a little tighter or more tense. So listen to your body and adjust. That's what yoga is about. Let's breathe as we move here. Yoga is very different than working out. Working out is externally focused with, you know, a certain amount of goals or number of reps or, you know. But yoga is focused on the inside, internally. How does it feel? What can you do today? Can you push yourself more? Or would it be better to stay where you are? It's more restorative, and it works on your parasympathetic nervous system. So hence it's more relaxing and rejuvenating to your body. You're bringing in a lot of oxygen, whereas working out, you're taxing your breath. So a lot of benefits to yoga. It's the overall practice, not just for flexibility, but for strength building, and really working on the mind, the body, and the soul all together. All right, let's inhale and reach the arms up. Inhale and exhale, bring your palms down to your heart. Reaching up tall. Exhale, palms into your heart. And one more breath and stretching up even taller. Exhale, down the center. Now let's get on our hands and knees again. So either roll over the knees, or just bring the legs out and come on your hands and knees. We're going to do the stray cat strut here. All right. It just mentioned about my music, but we're just going to keep on going through. We're going to provide the playlist that this music comes from. This music is not mine. I don't own it. But we're using it for this nonprofit organization, so I hope that they can understand. Let's move our hips side to side. All right, so now we're just going to do a little bit of strengthening here. So starting at tabletop, let's extend our right arm out, reaching out. And maybe this is what you do. Maybe just stretch your wrists here, and then you can go to the other arm. Or if you'd like to balance, reach your right arm out. Make sure this left hand is right under your shoulder so it can be stable for you. We're going to shift our weight to the right and extend our left leg out, flexing our toe down, straightening the knee, balancing here, breathing, building strength in our core and our spine. Let's come down and switch sides, extending the left arm and the right leg. Flexing the toe, straightening the knee, lifting both up and breathing. Let's come down. Let's go to the right side, right arm, left leg. And then, if possible, bend your knee, keeping that foot flat and flexed. Breathing. We're preparing for tiger pose coming up. Let's switch sides. Left arm, right leg. Bend the knee, flattening the foot, lifting and breathing. Let's come on down. Maybe shake the hips side to side. Shake your cat tail. All right, final asana before Shavasana. Let's bring our right arm out, left leg. Bend the knee, and if possible, maybe balance. Reach back and grab your ankle or your foot. If you're saying, no way, not today, that is okay. Just do what you can, maybe just reaching back, twisting. If you're here, lift up and breathe. Tiger pose. Let's relax down. Notice how I'm moving very slowly. I'm being gentle and mindful with my body, not just whipping it around. Let's extend our left arm out, right leg, one step at a time. Bending the knee, finding your balance. And then maybe reaching back for the ankle or the foot. And then here, lift the knee, lift the chest. Breathe in tiger pose. Then slowly bring it down. Let's come into a child's pose. Sitting back on our heels, reaching the arms out, relaxing the head down. And let's just take a few breaths here. Let's now slowly lift our head, inhale, and let's come up. We're going to come on our back now in Shavasana. So gently rotate around and come on your back. Let's reach our arms out, lengthening tall, and just relax your arms there. Maybe keep your knees bent. Let's put our knees into our chest and rock side to side. Hold on to your right knee, extend your left leg down. And then let's switch legs. Straight to the ground. Reach the arms up and lengthen your spine. As long as you can, reach your legs down and your arms up. Really lengthen here. And then relax all your muscles. If you still have some lower back pain here as you lay flat, maybe just bend a knee. Or if you have a block, you can maybe put a block right above, right on the tailbone. You can also put your knees so they're slightly bent. That can release some pressure as well. Or maybe elevate your legs, maybe on a chair or more cushions. But let's come to Shavasana. And let's bring our hands to our sides with our palms facing up. Allow your feet to fall to the side. And close your eyes. So we're now in Shavasana, also called corpse pose. We're just going to lay here like a dead body, but of course not dead, full of so much life, so much energy, vitality. We've just done a lot of movement and breathing, and so in yoga it's really important to bring a balance to it all, to give your body time to assimilate everything that has just been created in your practice. So let's relax here, relaxing every morsel of your being, your entire body, every muscle, every bone, every ligament, every joint. Hey, kitty, kitty. And let's just intentionally, purposely allow ourselves to relax here. Allow ourselves to fully surrender. See if you can allow yourself to relax. Give yourself this time to rest, even just for a few minutes. Think of it as your personal time out from the world. Oftentimes, we focus on what we're doing and how good we can do it and how fast we can move and how much we can accomplish. But it's really important to keep a balance by inviting some stillness into our lives. So let's do just that for these next few moments. Scan your body. See if you notice any areas where you're holding tension. And then visualize your breath as you're breathing, going into that space, relaxing the muscles. As you exhale, just softening a little more. With each inhale, we're creating space, expansion. With each exhale, we want to relax and let go in that space. So let's come into silence for a few moments. Just connect with our breath, connect with our body, and just observe our thoughts. We can't always stop our thoughts, but we cannot be entertained if we wish. So if you have a thought coming in, imagine it's on a bubble or a cloud just passing by. Witness, observe, and then let it go. And come back into this moment. Come back into your breath. And relax. Let's now take a deep breath in and sigh it out. Let's invite some small movement in our body, wiggling our fingers, our toes, moving your wrists, your ankles. And maybe take a nice stretch, whatever feels good in this moment. And then bring your knees into your chest. Side to side. Now we're going to roll to the right side. Over to the right, because it's a gentle way, being gentle on our heart being on this left side. Also, why they have the saying, get up on the right side of the bed. That way, if you wake up on the left, you're right away. So if you turn to the right, there's no pressure, it's gentle. And then with your left hand, you can just turn over, press yourself up, and let's come back to seated. Sitting up top, the mudra. We're joining cat yoga today at the Cats Cradle Yoga Sanctuary. If you're just tuning in now or you catched it halfway, feel free to hit the replay, baby, and play again. Please feel free to tag anyone that has lower back pain that could... Also, if you'd like to make a donation to the Cats Cradle, please visit cats-cradle.org, and you can make a donation to support all these lovely babies. And also, if you're interested in private yoga, I'm a private yoga instructor. I help people one-on-one, small groups. I specialize in yoga therapy, helping people rehabilitate past injuries, bringing the yoga to you. I also host special events like this one here, and I love working with nonprofit organizations. I love working with businesses, and also doing corporate yoga. So please feel free to reach out if you have any questions about my or Bruce and his lovely Cats Cradle Foundation. Yeah, we're still going live here.
I can be on camera, but
all right.
One exercise which you showed me is going to help my lower back.
Yes, I would love to help you.
That's the one where you...
is it the cow cat?
Stretch forward.
Uh-huh.
And then you rock back.
Yes.
Is that the right way to
do it? In the child's pose, I could show you right now.
Like
yes. So, flatten your toes. Usually we do yoga with no shoes, but that's okay. And then you're just going to sit back gently, gently, and then reach your arms out as much as you can. Bring your chest down to the ground. Relax your... It may seem like, oh, this is not that comfortable, right? It's kind of a little awkward, right? A little awkward? Yeah. Yeah, so at first this can be a little awkward, but just doing this... Yes. Yep. And then what I was doing was just doing some kind of rocking side to side. Really, we're just loosening up. Yes. Yep. And the hips. And because really the medicine's in the movement. Sometimes our muscles get tense. The fascia underneath builds up tension. But just by stretching, taking a few moments a day, or even once a week, it will start to get you more flexible and reduce pain.
Well, I thank you personally, and I may need more help.
All right. Well, I'll be glad to assist. Yeah, you and your wife. We could do family sessions.